They are the multi-ARIA award-winning pop duo who shot to fame more than 15 years ago. The Veronicas, twin sisters Lisa and Jessica Origliasso, have been keeping busy during the pandemic with not one, but two new albums, a new tour, plus preparing to headline the State of Origin. I sat down with Jess and Lisa for this deep and raw interview. Well, Lisa, Jess, lovely to see you both. Thank you very much for your time today. So you are on fire. When we ask people what they've been doing with their time during the downtime, there's no asking you. You got two albums coming out. Let's start with Godzilla. We've seen the title track. It's ball-tearing rock and roll. I absolutely love it.
Thank you. Talk to
me about it.
Mm. Yeah, Godzilla, we wrote, you know, guitars out. Like, this whole album is very much us going into the studio, starting with a lot of production or, like, raw sort of balls-to-the-wall elements.
And quite experimental on Godzilla.
And this one had a little bit of a metal kind of feel to it. Jess is screaming in it. I'm glad it's being channeled into the music and not at me. It's an absolute monster of a record.
It's like I'm Godzilla. I love you, I'll kill you.
When you sing, I love you, I'll kill you, is that at each other from those moments when you do have a sisterly squabble, shall we say?
Oh, definitely. I mean, there's always different elements in the songs that, like, embody our energy together, our energy with, like, sort of depending on who we're talking about. With that particular song, it was sort of our relationship with the Veronicas and then the Veronicas' relationship with the media. When something becomes larger than life, there's ever anything we don't really want to discuss or we want to be private about, we just don't really engage. But for the most part, we're a bit of an open book. Mm. But I think we say it the most eloquently through our music. That's the avenue I think we like to channel it all. Anything that humanizes you and there's something relatable, you know, most of the time that we're pretty comfortable talking about it, that, you know, whether that's relationship stuff, whether it's, you know, right now, like our grief with our mama's condition and situation. I think that being able to be vulnerable is a strength, and so that's really for us why we're pretty open.
We were chasing the moment.
Your story about your mum is so devastating, and it is one that is shared by so many people out there. The type of dementia she has, am I correct, it's the same one Robin Williams had?
Yeah, so essentially there's a condition that she has, it's a rare neurological disease called progressive supranuclear palsy, and within that it has different symptoms that are similar and also along the lines of Lewy bodies dementia as well. So there's a few different diagnoses. Yeah, and Robin Williams did have the Lewy bodies dementia, which can cause hallucinations, memory loss, huge amount of pain and confusion. And it's, unfortunately, these neurological conditions are incredibly hard to diagnose because a lot of them, you can have multiple things. There's a lot of crossover symptoms. And so for us, you know, we really try to raise awareness now for early diagnosis, being able to really stay on top of your brain health. You're the only high I need. Our journey with our mummy has been one we've been learning as time goes because there isn't a lot of research to do with this condition or many neurological conditions.
It's still so unknown, so much of it.
So that's why, you know, we
talk about it.
We talk about it, yeah.
Tell me, when she hears your music, is that a positive for her? Does she take enjoyment from that?
So much. She's always been our biggest fan. She came on tour with us for a very long time. She was tour mom to, you know, more than just us, our whole band, crew, the fans. The music is other way of communicating. It's our special language.
And not even just
well.
our music, but also like, you
music,
know, her favorite music growing up, like, you know, Skyhooks,
Katie Lang,
all the iconic Australian rock and roll, like she loves it. And when she hears it, you know, it accesses a part of the brain that does unlock memories. And it's incredible to see the effect that music has on the brain specifically. It's beautiful.
When I look into your eyes. Lisa, and again, it's something personal to you and human, but you revealed that you'd had an ectopic pregnancy with your husband.
Yeah, last
again,
year.
Something a lot of people go through. How have you coped with that?
Yeah, I mean, it's a part of this human, you know, experience that we're all on. And for me, it was very cathartic to share it. I think when I found out I was pregnant, I was overjoyed. Obviously, I wanted to share that news with the world. So when we lost the pregnancy, I definitely felt like it was something that I wanted to share, because we have a platform to share things, to just celebrate all the highlights of life. And again, the human experiences, it's the light and the dark, it's the highs and the lows, and life isn't always perfect and rainbows. And yeah, it was a very, very difficult time in my life. I was really missing my mummy throughout that. But hopefully, God willing, in the future, we'll have some babies.
It's been 5 months, 9 hours, 42 seconds since I left home.
You've never played State of Origin?
We haven't.
I heard a little whisper that that might be happening. Is that true?
Yes. It is true. And this is a full circle moment for us. We were just saying we grew up watching the State of Origin with our dad every year, and like 80,000 people in a stadium is...
I mean, what
terrifying.
A way to celebrate coming back to the stage as well after, you know, 12 months of, you know, not really being able to play any music at all.
Is it a secret what you're going to perform?
We're actually doing a medley of stuff, so we're doing about 6 or 7 different songs, and we're doing a massive show. We were like, this is our Australian Super Bowl.
Yeah,
like
100%.
We have to make this amazing. So, you know, we've put huge production into this, and we're doing like an awesome amount of songs. So we hope people love it.
I've just seen some behind-the-scenes vision of you guys posing for your Stella cover.
Oh, yeah.
Do you like doing that sort of thing? Do you like doing the fashion?
Oh, yeah. We've always loved fashion. You know, getting to dress up and creatively, again, it just, it's creativity, it's expression of self. And that was really fun because we looked different to how we usually look.
Yes.
It was a very different thing for us. It was letting our Italian heritage really fly, I feel, which, you know, we haven't had a chance to do that a lot. When it's up to us, we're always in black latex, whereas this was very colourful. And a bit more femme, so...
What does the black latex thing say? What's the message we take from that?
Don't mess with us. Really tends to be our MO, doesn't it?
I love it. It's been great to talk to you both. Thank you so much for your time today.
Thank you.
Pure joy. Gosh, we've got some amazingly talented people in this country,
oh,
do we not?
Sure.
Those girls are amazing.
And always good to hear when the State of Origin actually remembers that there are female performers.
Yeah.
And hires them. Not just always about the blokes, because they rock as
oh,
much as
yeah.
You know, many of the big rock bands. So yeah, just gonna be amazing.